Hello. I was very, very sad to hear the untimely death of Nikki Grahame, so I've decided to put this together.
I don't know what's going to happen 1 minute from the next. I'm really not high maintenance. I can be a little bit up and down. So self-absorbed. Me. I can't control what comes out my mouth. It's in my mind, and then I've said it. And then it's too late. And then I think... Who is she? Who is she? Who is she? Where
Just
did you find
watch
her?
Me and listen to me for hours, because I go on and on and on. My main ambition is to marry me a shit footballer. I'm not designed to be a pauper and I hate it and it makes me miserable. One day I'm going to marry a rich man and I'm just going to have his credit card and go off and get my nails done and my hair and go out for lunch. That's just all I want
Nikki
out of life.
Nikki is in the dining room.
Feeling very venomous and angry.
I can't get my MP3 player to work! It's not fair, don't you know how to switch it on? Oh, it's working.
That's my bed. Nikki's bed. That's mine. That's my bed.
He's ousted me out, and it's not fair.
What's wrong with you swines? You're fucking swines.
I'm so cold. I'm too angry to talk. I want to smash someone's head in. I hate her. I tell you now. I'm going to find it very difficult to be pleasant to it for the rest of this week, I'm afraid. I can feel the venom pouring out of me as I breathe.
Fuckers.
I'm the best fucking actor out there and I get all the crap people.
Nikki has been in the diary room for 3 minutes, crying.
I wanted an award.
She's got that bottle of champagne in her room. She'll lick it. Shall we? It's so fucking
funny.
What made you a legend? I never claimed to be one. They invited me back
in. No, you never were, darling.
But what are you?
You're a f***ing hated figure.
What are you?
I'm a legend. I am a f***ing legend. As was
Bang.
I believe that Nikki Grahame was very misunderstood. I don't think she really understood herself a lot of the time. And she was a vulnerable adult. And she was lovely. She also threw many, many tantrums. And she was still lovely. Rest in peace, Nikki. Much, much love.
When I found out she was ill, I knew Nikki was ill in the last lockdown. You know, she told me not to say, and she was getting care, you know. But, she rang me up and was like, Pete, I'm ill, come and get me in the clinic. And, I remember seeing that, seeing the fundraiser that Carly and Leon had made. I was in London at the time and I just got in the cab and went over there with my girlfriend, who's a mental health nurse. And we just tried to, you know, give her as much love and support. And because it was me, you know, me and Nikki have a great connection. So I thought that would just boost her up and get her out of the darkness, you know. And because this lockdown has been really hard for people with mental health issues. like, this has really highlighted it. You know, look what it's done. You know what I mean? It's taken one of the, you know, one of the best characters the world's ever, you know, seen. It's just rubbish, man, you know. So, heart goes out to all her fans. I'm getting so many nice messages. Thank you so much for all the lovely support that all her fans and the Big Brother 7 fans have been giving me, and to the rest of the Big Brother's cast. We've all been getting so much love, and we really appreciate it. I can say that we're all really cut up, and I can't really put it into words yet. It's still really
quite a sore subject. I just want to say thank you for all your support and love since the fundraiser came out. I think that was amazing what we achieved. We got loads of money, and the amount of love and support for Nikki was overwhelming, and I was like, yeah, really, like, heartwarming is a good word for it. I thought to myself, yeah, we can save her. It's okay, she's in a good place. She's not suffering anymore. So, I would just like to raise a fucking glass. A fucking bottle of wine, more like, for Nikki Grahame. And all the love from us at Big Brother 7. Now, we really love you. We really love you, Nick, man. You were a true winner, man. You know, you were great. You fucking rocked it, babes.